Good morning, everybody. Welcome to my channel. I do apologise for anything you may see. Let me just turn those hazards off. They're annoying. Do the window up. Right, so yeah, we've just been and done a delivery. I was going to start this video a little bit earlier, but it was dark. So yeah, by the time I got here, it was dark. So I'm starting it now. We just delivered a load of bags to, where is it? KRM Building Supplies is where we've just been. And we've now got to make our way to Suez in Birmingham, S-U-E-Z. And basically I'm just preparing because I'm pretty sure I'm going to need to wear these. And I've got shorts on at the moment, so yeah, well, I'll put them on when we get there. They just slip straight over my boots. Right, let's put my shoes back on. Yeah, so, sorry, it's a bit of an awkward start to the video, I do understand. Right, audio. Stop going on about audio. Yes, the microphone. I used to have a GoPro Hero 3, well, I still got it, and I had a dedicated mic that plugged in here. Well, sorry, connected to me here. And then it went into the GoPro, which was then in my pocket. The mic is not damaged, the mic is fine. I bought another mic to replace it, thinking it was the mic that was broke. And it was absolutely fine. The problem is the connector on the GoPro. Now the issue I had is I had another GoPro. What do we need to go out of here? Left by the looks of it. I had another GoPro, but the SD card on that one was damaged. The insert. You could put a card in and it'd be difficult to get back out. So basically I've got two GoPro Hero 3s and they're knackered. luckily I've got two GoPro Hero 5s and I bought this device that I've got right now. I'll see if I can take a picture of it or something later. Hang on, while I'm waiting to get out I can show you yourself. So that's what you look like. That's what you're seeing me on right now. I actually bought it specifically for Norway to do my vlog. So I bought it a good sort of like, I was in January, we're in November now, so I bought it like a good 9 months ago and I haven't used it since. So now I'm using it instead of the GoPro Hero 3 with a dedicated mic. Now the downside is I won't be able to jump out the cab and talk to people and you won't be able to hear what's being said, for example, at security gates. That's the downside, but the good side is I should have relatively good crystal audio. Not only that, but editing is going to be slightly easier because rather than syncing up three separate GoPros over a whole vlog, and you're talking like maybe between 30 and 60 different clips that need to be synchronized, 30 to 60, we're now probably looking at 10 to 20 instead clips. Maybe 20 to 30. So point is, rather than syncing up three GoPros, we're only going to be syncing up two GoPros from now on, as long as I use this setup. So yeah, anyway, we've got to watch our speed because apparently there's a school route down here. Anyway, plan for the day. So we're going to go to Suez in Birmingham. We've got to get loaded with baled waste. That's got to go to Swindon Recycling Centre, Thamesdown, off the 419. From there, once tipped, we've then got to go to the range in Mitchell Dean, get reloaded for a delivery down in Bournemouth and Dorchester tomorrow. So yeah, depending on the length of this video, you might see that tomorrow. I'm not sure. I might split this over 2 days. Yeah, that's the plan. So welcome to the vlog, welcome to the channel. My name is Luke, if you didn't know. And yeah, let's get crack-a-lacking. Let's get the day going and I'll see you when we get to Birmingham, which is about an hour away. See you in a bit. Okay, we are in Birmingham. We are about a mile away from our destination. Before we left, actually yesterday when I got told I was coming to this place, I was googling it because I've never been here before. So I was googling it to see what I need to do. Looks like you can go straight in from, well, there's a security hut there. The problem is they've got a weighbridge with like a little bit of a slip road where like you could probably get three, maybe four trucks lined up onto the weighbridge. And the weighbridge is for them. But I don't know whether I got to go on the weighbridge first or not. I don't. The problem I got is I don't want to queue up for the weighbridge. I get blocked in and then find out I've not got to go on the weighbridge. That's what's going to annoy me. But I would have thought I've got to go on the weighbridge. I'm gonna guess I need to anyway. So yeah, basically I am going to go onto the weighbridge or line up for said weighbridge. Something about money there, seatbelt. There's a homeless guy there. Asking for money. There's also a bloke on his phone. Sat in traffic. So I'm gonna line up for the weighbridge, and then if I'm the only one there, then hopefully there's a what was he doing? Can you see that? There's a bloke there just asking for money. Yeah, if there is a weighbridge, hopefully there's an intercom or something that I can talk to him on. If not, I'll have to get out and walk over to the security hut. I believe I'm booked in for 9 o'clock, and I'm going to be there at 9:45, so I am late, which means they either won't get me in or they will, but hopefully they get me in because I'm due. Whereas if I was like 2 hours early, they might tell me to go away and come back later, so at least I'm due. So that's partly good. Where's that bloke gone? Oh, he's walking up the road. So yeah, it's just, that's the thing, when you've not been somewhere before, you've got to work it all out. There's another one there. And another one. Is that another one? Those people are asking for money here and stuff. Hopefully we can get let in quite quickly, and then like I said, it's got to go back to Swindon. And all I know is it's baled waste, so it could be anything. I'm going to assume it's like plastic bottles and stuff, like crushed into like a square. That's what I'm going to assume. Last time I took metal, aluminium, which was awkward because they stacked it really quite high, and I could barely get the internals over it. Yes, so reference is. Say that again, didn't hear you, sorry.
Just give me a few minutes, yep. And wait for the buyer to come on.
Okay, thank you. Wait 2 minutes, wait for the barrier to come up. It's very noisy out there with the trucks, with those container lorries. They've got their engines capped on. Looks like they're going down to the next place, look, but there's a keep clear sign there. So now we wait. 2 minutes, she said. There's a sign here. It says failure to strap each bale stack may result in your entire load being rejected on delivery. And the picture shows internals. Oh, barrier's gone up, barrier's up, barrier's up. Right, green light, where do I go then? Change gear. It's in drive, and you didn't want to change gear. Didn't want to. Come on, let's go. Thank you. Hello. Yep. So go left up there, then turn around and come back. Okay, no problem. All right, thank you. Right, that was a lot of roars. Right, we are loaded. Whew. There's a load of cans, like beer cans, Coke cans, that sort of stuff. Sorry, a little bit out of breath. They have put it quite high, but the load itself isn't as wide as the trailer. So putting the internals over them were a lot easier than it was last time. Because the rail, basically the cans are like in line with the rail, so I could quite easily get it round and over. Whereas before, the rail was about sort of 30 centimeters in from the outside of the trailer. And before, the load was as wide as the trailer, so it was a lot harder to get the straps around. But no, it was really easy this time, so that's good. So yeah, we're just going to make our way back towards Swindon now. Hopefully it'll take a little over an hour to get there. I don't know whether I've got to do anything with security here. We'll find out in a minute. But yeah, actually, overall, it wasn't too bad. We got here just before 10 o'clock, I think, and it's 11 o'clock now, so we're here for about an hour. We had to wait for another truck to get loaded, but we were only waiting sort of like 20 minutes. Actually, it might have been 30 minutes, I can't remember. Wasn't paying too much attention. Right, let's see whether we need to do anything here. Probably need to get some paperwork actually with the delivery address on, I suspect. Thank you. Yeah. Alright, have a good day, bye. Alright, just the one copy. Double check the address it's going to. Yeah, seems to match, and we weigh 15 ton, 320 kilograms. 15 ton is what we weigh. So that's the net. The gross is 30. 31 nearly. We weigh nearly 30 ton, and we can carry, well, we can weigh up to 44 ton, so. We are 14 ton light to our maximum capacity, which means you can go a little bit faster. Once he goes, we're clear. Excellente. Yeah, so we're going to make our way back to Swindon now. There is a big delay on the M5 by Worcester, so we may need to end up taking a diversion. I feel like I've cut myself, but I haven't. There's no blood or anything. Like I said, I'm dealing with cans and I had gloves on, but like, kind of feels like I've got like a tingly sensation, but there's no cuts. I'm having a stroke or something. Better not say that. So let's make our way back to towards Swindon now. Half an hour, about 40 minute delay now on the M5 come Worcester, so we're definitely going to be taking a diversion at some point. But we'll see when we get there. So we'll have a break as well, probably on the way down, so yes. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, situation update. So the M5 has completely closed now. There appears to have been an overturned lorry on the M5. So yeah, the Matrix sign was saying delay 30 minutes, as I knew of before I left Birmingham. But the sat-nav was saying it was completely closed. So it was trying to divert me through Worcester, but of course everyone else is going through Worcester as well. So traffic was building up. And then there was an hour delay, even like going through Worcester. And I'm busy today. I've got stuff that needs to be delivered, and I've got to go get reloaded yet, and then go back home. So what I've decided to do, and it's a little bit of a detour, it's an extra 10 miles, but I've come off the 42 onto the M40, which is where I am now, and then I'm going to come off at Warwick, and then go on the 429 via Sherborne, I think it's Sherborne. 429 and take that all the way to Sirens and stuff, 429, the A49 there, and essentially go through the Cotswolds. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. It's a little bit annoying because it's added an extra, I think it was 20 minutes onto the journey time, but it's only 20 minutes compared to the hour it would have been if I was sat in the traffic. So, and I've got to get reloaded yet before they go home. I'm not entirely sure what time they go home. And I've got to get offloaded yet as well, so time is of essence. So that's what we're doing right now. For some reason we're going really slowly behind this caravan and a lorry in front, but we're coming off in a mile, so I'll just stick a late one. Right, I'll see you in a bit.
My hands are tied, do you resonate inside my bones? Don't know why I'm incapable, why you're unstoppable. Someone
Okay, situation is this. So there's a quick lay there. We're just going to go past quick lay now. Thamesdown Recycling, which is where we're going, is on the other side of this dual carriageway. Now, there is a turning, a right turning that I can do, but it involves crossing the dual carriageway. And it's notoriously bad. You could be waiting a long time to get out sometimes. So what I'm doing right now is just judging the 419, seeing how busy it is, and whether I can make it. I'm gonna get in the right-hand side lane just in case I do decide, but I might bail last minute. I'm also indicating. It's doable, I think. Thing is, if I do this, I save a lot of time. If I don't do this, I've got to go all the way up, back down again. And it could take a good 10-15 minutes off your driving time. It's quiet at the moment, but you wait, as soon as I get there, it's going to get busy. I've got to time it so I can go out straight away. Oh yeah, it's getting busy now, look. God damn it, if I was a good 30 seconds earlier, I would have made that cut that space there. It was predictable. Come on, van. If that van wasn't there, I would have made that. Yeah, so this is the issue now, where you're waiting. But at least your driving time isn't getting taken up. But yeah, it's just annoying, because you want to ideally just go straight on without having to stop. We could be here a while. Okay, is that a space? Ugh! What we want is the car to pass here and just see someone coming over. That's what we want. And everyone ideally to be in lane one so I can get into lane two. Start accelerating. Right, we might have a space here. Yeah, we got a space. Woo! Nothing coming. That's the space we wanted. Ah, there's no one coming for ages. And when you come out of here, you get banned apparently if you turn right. You've got to turn left apparently. Anyway, we're going to need a hard hat. I've also got my induction card. You've got to get inducted in. You've got to show this every time you turn up. So apparently, he's having a good old look at me. What is that? Maybe I wasn't supposed to turn right. Right, hard hat. See you in a bit. Okay, we are unloaded and we are just about to head out. Unfortunately, we've got to get back on to the A419 now. So the same issue we had crossing it, we've now got to join back up, and we are behind a container truck as well, so we've got to wait for him to come off. We got here about an hour ago, so we haven't been here that long. We've only been here an hour, so all good. And it's only an hour back down, well, back up rather, to Gloucester. So yeah, we're going to head there now, get reloaded for the range tomorrow. And then we've been told that we've got to be in Dorchester tomorrow by 8 a.m. at the latest, because there is a train station right there. So yeah, we've got to get there nice and early before the train station opens or whatever, or people try getting a train. See, if these cars moved into lane two, there's just a red car here in lane one, which is actually stopping me from getting out. So I've got to, given the movement, if you move over, then I could have gotten out, mate. But never mind. Right, we're out. Anyway, that's the main thing. Let's get crack-a-lacking. Oh, before we go, I bought some wheel brake for my Honda, for my Type R. Try and keep those wheels nice and clean. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, right, we are literally just about to turn right into the destination where we're going next. So yeah, we're heading to the range to be loaded. Two stores, Dorchester and, was it Bournemouth? I think it might be Bournemouth, I can't remember. Pretty sure it was. I've definitely been here once before, but I can't remember if I've been here twice or not. Yeah, I've been here twice. Yeah, definitely been here twice. I just had to remember that. So, I should know where I'm going. Fingers crossed. Okay, right, because we need to do a right-hand turn. And it's clear, so we can go straight across. Lovely. Still double-check, though. Right, hopefully, security man will let me in without stopping me. That'd be nice. Barrier is down at the moment. Is he going to lift it up? Bow, 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 bow. Okay, I don't think there's anyone at the machine, at the screen rather. Oh, he's opened it. Thank you very much. Welcome to Vantage Point Business Park. We are getting loaded straight on, but we've got to go around in a big old circle just to get there. I remember now, I got loaded ones for someone else. Yeah, I come here, I got the trailer loaded, parked up. It was a Friday evening, I remember now. It looks like there is space for me to be loaded. So hopefully I just turn up around the corner and someone will come over to me. Fingers crossed. This right here? I think it was this right. I hope it's this right. I'm pretty sure it is. Yeah. Yeah, this is the one. Turn right again. And we just park up down here on the right hand side. I think someone comes up to me. Wow. Yeah, is that forklift coming up to me now? I think he is. No, he's not. Okay. So the last two times I've been here, someone's come over to me. So I'm just going to sit tight until they do that again. But they might not. They might not. Anyway, I'm going to get loaded. Hopefully we won't be here too long. It's 20 past three now. I'm hoping to be out by 20 past four. See you in a bit. Turn my dead cat around a little bit. We're loaded. Can't remember what time we got here. I'm pretty sure it was 20 past three, something like that. And I'm pretty sure I said I wanted to be out of here in an hour. Wow! Ladies and gentlemen, that happened. It is literally an hour since I've been here. It's 4:15 now. Which is good. It takes about an hour to get back to the yard, so we should be in the yard for about 5:15. By the time we park up, get out, get home, it'd be 5:30. Because I literally live around the corner, pretty much. Right, and I've actually got to go because my mum's calling me right now. See you in a bit. Right, do apologise. As I said, that was my mum just calling. As you guys know, I'm getting married at the end of this year, and good old Boris Johnson has now reduced it down to 15 guests, which means quite a lot of guests that we had invited are no longer invited. So, it's a bit of a nuisance, to be honest, telling people sorry but you can't come, you're not quite high up the list. me and my girlfriend, right, so it's me, we've got our two kids, which is four, and then it's our I got four family members coming, she's got four family members coming, and then essentially one friend each. That puts us up to 14 guests, and then we got the photographer, which apparently counts as a guest, so that's 15. And then the registrar, which apparently counts as a guest, and that's 16. So we're actually technically one over. But we're going to see what we can do, because obviously the registrar isn't staying too long, and the photographer could potentially work around around us so that she's not in the same room at the same time. I don't know. It's all like up in the air at the moment. A little bit of stress, not going to lie. But that's it. End of November, so not long left. 10 weeks, if that. Maybe 9. Never mind. Anyway, as I was saying, we are now loaded. We've got approximately 21 pallets on, I believe. Some of them are oversized, not in terms of weight, just in terms of how big they are. So, but we are filled up, basically. We got a go to Dorchester in the morning. I believe there's 5 for Dorchester, and then the rest of them for Bournemouth. So yes, that's what we're going to do tomorrow. And there's no point carrying on talking now. I will see you in the morning when we are just around the corner from Dorchester. Which lane do I need to be in? Which lane do I need to... I think I need to be in the right-hand side lane. Yes, I do. 100%. 100% need to be in this lane. There we go. Yeah, so I'm going to see you in a second. It'll be the next day, i.e. tomorrow. And we will be on our way down to Dorchester. See you in a bit.
I was so lost, like a vagabond with no home. Moving on into the wilderness, somewhere my emptiness. A lack of faith, while the time was running out for me. There's no escape from the mess I made. When you come, everything just turns around. I get stunned by your drum. I follow you into the sun. Shooting rays like a shotgun. You gotta be my someone.
It is the next day. We left the yard about 5 a.m. this morning. It's now 7:30. So yeah, we've been at it for 2.5 hours on the road. And we're about 8 miles away from the destination. So hopefully we'll be there pretty soon. Now, we were told to get there before 8 a.m. Our current ETA is just after 7:45. So we're at the moment, we're on target. We're a good 15 minutes before the latest we can get there. But it was touch and go. It was touch and go. When I left the yard this morning, it said I had 5 minutes to spare. I was like, oh no, I may have misjudged this. But we've actually made up a little bit of time. So, like I said, we're only 8 miles away now. So hopefully it's all going to be good. Now, I'm wearing my glasses because I normally wear them when it's dark out. It just helps me see a little bit better. Don't need to wear glasses to drive, but it does make things in HD. So I tend to wear them during the evenings when it's dark, or in the mornings when it's dark, just to help me see a little bit. And actually, truth be told, I don't need to wear them anymore because it's quite light out now. So yes. So yeah, I'm going to carry on making my way to the first drop. I will see you when we get there. Apparently, when I get there, I'm going to be like, is this the place? And I got to go parallel to a train track and bloody, bloody, bloody. But I've been down some really dodgy roads, so hopefully. It's not going to be anything different to what I'm used to. But yeah, see you in a bit. Right. We are just going down here, I believe. You flashed me out?
Yeah.
Go. Trying to change gear on the old truck, but it wasn't having it. I am not 100% sure this is the right way to go. I think I should have carried on going that way a little bit more. Never mind. Ah, there's an Arctic there. That's good. We can go down this way. I've got got my sat nav taking me there, and I've also got my phone taking me there as well. Straight up that hill. Bam, bam, bam. I think we could have gone the other way as well. I'm not sure. Anyway, we're only 1/2 mile away, so should be there. It's literally 7:45 right now, so hopefully we can get straight in. We've only got 5 pallets to come off as well, so we shouldn't be there too long. Straight back out and then go to the next job. Right, we're gonna go left here. Where's that van going? Is he slowing? He is slowing. I can't go until that car comes to the left. Because I need to go on his side of the road. Down here we go. We've got to go right to the train track. And not go under any bridges that are too low, because it will damage the trailer. It's a bit narrow here, mate. Wait there. Thank you. Just wind the pedestrian on the left. Okay, one-way street, that's good. Although there is a bit of a bollard down there. Have I gone the right way? I don't know. I really don't know. This is going to be annoying to get out. Go down here. Should be good now, we should be good. I don't think that was the best way to come in. I'm not sure. It wasn't bad, it wasn't too bad. But there might have been a better way of coming in. Turn right, then turn left. Turn right, and then turn left. Got to get a break in at some point as well. We might be able to get to the next door without having a break. I think we can. And then we'll have to have a break from there. So we stop somewhere on the way back is what I'm looking at. We're on 2:45 now, so by the time we get here, it'll be about three hours driving. And I think it's an hour to the next door. So that would leave me half an hour to park up. There's the range. Bam, bam. Can't actually go anywhere yet. I can't go any further forward because I'll be blocking people who want to go left. Right. There's the train station. We want to go left down here. Just a little bit narrow, but we'll make it. Just want to mind the trailer on that corner there. Loads of room. Excellent, car park is empty, that's what we want. Seatbelt is off because we are now in a public area. And goods in entrance is just here. I'm going to spin around and reverse back. I'm facing the right way then. Although I'm not entirely sure where he wants me. Go speak to them and see where they want me exactly, and then we'll go from there. See you in a bit. Right, we're done. Sorry, I was just laughing then because I just realised what the time is. It's 8:10. That'll do. That was nice and quick. Right, destination. Yeah, I've got to thank my good friend Kev T. He is around this area, so he's given me directions to this store, and he's also given me rough directions to the next store as well in Bournemouth, like where to go. So hopefully we can get there straight away. Now obviously the way we come in, it's going to be different to the way we go out, because the way we come in was a one-way system, well, part of it anyway. So the way out is going to be a little bit different, but let's give it a go. like I said, my well, I haven't said my sat nav is a truck sat nav, so it should avoid any low bridges. Where do you want me to go? Want me to reverse? So yeah, it should avoid low bridges, and I'm 13.2 in feet. I'm 4 meters. I know I'm 4 meters, but in feet it's 13.2. I think some people think I'm smaller than I actually am. Truck size, that is. Right, we're going straight down here and then a nasty right hand turn by the looks of it. I'm just wondering if turning right here would be best. The back of the vehicle is like 45 foot behind me, and turning sharp right sometimes means the back wheels won't go over like bollards or whatever. A bit like when I was in London, when I had that cock up. If you wait there, mate, I ain't got room. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm just gonna wait here, just so vehicles can get past. If I go up to that car there, then my trailer's gonna be on this keep clear sign, but it's green light now, so I'm gonna start moving. And the right turn looks like it's gonna be no problem whatsoever, other than the fact I've got to give way. Lovely jubbly, start indicating, turning right. Clear to left after that car, clear to the right, clear left, clear right. Lovely. Okay. I think that was the worst of it. I think so. Anyway, we've got waste on. We've got some pallets with cardboard on. This is like cardboard packaging. They take it back to be recycled. So once we've done this drop in Bournemouth, we are then going to need to go to Avonmouth to get all the recycled waste offloaded so they can recycle it. And then I believe from there, I'm driving straight to Tetbury, I believe, to get reloaded for tomorrow. But we shall see. We're on 2 hours and 50 minutes of driving. We're only 45 minutes away from our next drop, so yeah, we're going to be on, what, 3.30, 3.35, something like that. What time we get there? 3.40? Maybe 3.40, which means we'll have 50 minutes of driving time before we have to stop. So yeah, plenty of time. Right, see you in a bit.
Everything just turns around. I get stunned by your drum. I follow you into the sun. Shooting rays like a shotgun. You gotta be my someone.
We are now offloaded. Let's get out of here. I am waiting for confirmation to find out where I'm taking this. I believe I'm taking it to Avonmouth, but that was mentioned yesterday and things change. I've phoned the boss twice, but I've not yet received an answer, so I'm just going to make my way towards there now. Hopefully I'll get a phone call back. It's a good 3 hours there anyway. Right, situation is we got offloaded here and then we had a break here. We had a break here, reset the driving time. Now we can just drive straight out. Yeah, it's been really good actually. They got it off really quickly, got me reloaded really quickly, got all my curtains closed up, and yeah, just been chilling on Facebook. I've put a bit of a controversial post up, and let's just say it's got a few backs up. It's causing some people to unsubscribe and unfollow, which is fine. I completely expected that. So no real loss. It's a shame, but no real loss. Right, so yeah, 3 hour drive pretty much to Avonmouth. Let's get this tipped off and then we'll see what we're doing from there. Could change. See you in a bit. Right, we're done. Gate pass is there. Lovely jubbly. Right, so situation is, we are now tipped. The recycling side of things are tipped anyway. Where's he going? Yeah, recycling is now, it's been tipped. So now we need to go get loaded. From Tetbury. I'm not entirely sure which way to go though. There's been a massive accident on the M4, junction 17 to 18, that's Chippenham to Bath, which is one of the reasons why I had to come around the long way to get here in the first place. From Bournemouth, what I would have probably have done is gone up the A34, M4, M5. Actually, you don't even touch the M5, you just come off the M4. But instead, we had to go via Yeovil, A31, I think it is, 35, something like that. And come up that way, come down the south side of the M5 and work our way up, coming that way. And then there's a road closure, so I had to come in the other way to this site. So it's a little bit annoying. And yeah, truth be told, I am not entirely sure which way to get to where I need to be. Okay, here we go. That Grundon's has gone straight out. Just line ourselves up. Oi, mate.
Just got a silent print there for me.
Yeah, will do. There we go, buddy.
Cheers.
All right, have a good day. Sign and print. I literally just scribbled. Like, what's the point? Do you know what I mean? Anyway, there's a lot of big old companies around here. That DHL warehouse, look. It seems like DHL are the only ones that like put effort into the way their warehouse looks. I mean, it looks smart, looks modern. But yeah, there's loads of big old places around here, like DHL, Davis Turner, Range. There's a Lidl around the corner. Amazon, big old Amazon depot. Yeah, big old area for industry, haulage industry, and trucks and shops. Right, so we are going to crack on to Tetbury now. We should be there for about 2:15. By the time I get loaded out of there, get back to the yard, it'll be about 2:15. No, by the time I get out of there, it should be about 3:15, hopefully. As long as I'm not there too long. And then back in the yard for about 4:15. I've then got to drop the trailer and go get another trailer from a place in Swindon. And then bring that back, and then drop that trailer, then hook up back to mine. So we're looking about 5 o'clock finish, but it depends on how long it takes to get loaded out of Tetbury, really. But we will see. We will see. Right, let's get crack-a-lacking. I'll see you in a bit. Right, okay, we're just around the corner now from where we're getting loaded in Tetbury. We're getting loaded from a company called Melcourt. Been here quite a few times now to be loaded, and they're definitely a nice bunch of guys. I don't know for sure yet, but I've been given my reference, and I've been told the place I'm going, roughly, like the area. I'm going to a place called Morden. Now, I went to Morden last week, and I got there at 2:20 PM, obviously. And I got there, and they said, sorry mate, we don't take deliveries after 2 o'clock. I was like, you what? No deliveries, I was 2 o'clock. I was like, okay, so I phoned them up, this and these guys, and they weren't too happy, but I don't think they were told or anything, so I had to bring them back, basically. But yeah, I think I'm going there tomorrow, but only there, so I should be there first thing in the morning. They don't open till 9 o'clock. It's a garden centre. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see whether that is where we're going. I suspect it is, but we'll wait and find out. But the annoying thing is that there was a 7.5-tonne truck pulled in behind me, and he had one pallet come off that needed coming off. Bear in mind, I only needed 11 pallets to come off, I think, maybe 12. Yeah, it was 12. And I know why, I'll tell you why in a sec. So the guy behind me had one pallet, and he said, no, sorry, we can't tip you, we don't do deliveries after 2 o'clock. Next minute, they're tipping him, they're taking the pallet off. So I said, why are you taking the pallet off him, but not me? So, and then he tried saying, oh, there's only one pallet, so they can get away with it. I said, all right, okay. I said, well, why don't you take one pallet off me, I'll go out, and I'll come back in 10 more times, or 11 more times, or whatever I said. Yeah, it was 11. So, a little bit of a joke, but, yeah. Yeah, it's quite funny, quite funny. Anyway, we should be on. We've got to keep an eye out for trucks coming out. There's a walking floor going in, so that's good. I got a load of motorcyclists behind me, so I'm just trying to keep an eye on them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 or 5, I think. Yeah, we can make this turn before that cyclist comes down. Here we go. Right, so yeah, there's a walking floor up there, and then there's no other truck, so we should be the next one in, as long as my stuff's here. Last time I come here, they didn't have any topsoil or something, so I had to wait for some walking floors to come in to deliver some, so then they can put it in a bag and then put it on the trailer. But I'm hoping it's all pallets. That would be nice if it's all pallets. It'd be nice and quick. And then got to go and drop this trailer off, and then go and get the other trailer from Swindon Trailers. A lot of trailers in that sentence there. Right, anyway, I'm going to park up behind this truck here. I'm going to go and get me paperwork, and then we will find out where we're going. But yeah, I think it's going to be Morden Garden Centre in the outskirts of London, well, pretty much in London, but yeah. Right, see you in a bit. Right, we're loaded, we're just on the weighbridge. All strapped up, ready to go. Just got to get the thumbs up to say we're good. And off we go. Right, so next destination is to go back to the yard, drop this trailer off, and then I believe we've got to go and get the other trailer. Problem is, I've only got 50 minutes of drive time, so I'm gonna have to go back to the yard, drop the trailer, have half an hour break before I actually go pick up this trailer, which is annoying, to be honest. So, but never mind, it's got to be done, so. Yes, anyway, I'm going to go drop this trailer off. I'll see you when we're on our way to get in the other trailer. See you in a bit. Right, we're on the move. We dropped the trailer. I can't remember what I did now. Did you see me drop the trailer? I don't think you didn't see me drop the trailer. Anyway, I dropped the trailer, and I've had to have a break, because I ran out of driving time. So we've been parked up in the yard for half an hour. We're now on our way to go and get the new trailer. I say new, it's brand new, second hand. maybe 10 hand, I don't know. All I know is where I've got to go and what I've got to pick up. So that's what we're going to do. You forget how much power the truck has when you haven't got a trailer on as well. Just pause and put that aircon on, it's a bit off. So yeah, we're gonna go grab this trailer, hook up to it, bring it back, then we've got to drop it off, and then we've got to hook back up to my trailer ready for the morning. And then tomorrow I'm going towards London. I've already given my call. It wasn't the same place I went to last time, don't know if I've said. It's a different garden centre in the same place. And they open up at 9 a.m, but they're gonna get in for 8 a.m. to let me in. So happy days. So yeah, right, let's go get this trailer. See you in a bit. Right. Trailer is on. My boss is actually over there. I turned up and he was here. He's getting an inspection done on his trailer. So, happy days. Watch this vibrating. Huh. Yeah, so, what is the time? It's 5 o'clock. 5 to 5, anyway. So we head back to the yard now. We'll be there in like 15 minutes. Drop this trailer off. Hitch back up to my one and then go home. So yeah, thank you very much for watching this video, I do appreciate it, and I will see you soon in the next one. Remember to drive safe, stay safe, see you soon, bye bye.